So recently, LEGO announced that they're making a set based on the 1975 film Jaws. The only problem, it's $150. And like a lot of LEGO sets these days, that's quite expensive for most people. So let's dive in and build something a bit different. First off, we need to build the diorama base that everything will sit on. And this is quite simple, we'll just be stacking some plates, tiles, as well as some dark blue plates for the ocean water. Similar to the idea set, I've used the same claw element that forms the seafoam effect where the water meets the edge of the display. And we actually have something a little bit different than the official idea set. I've attached the shark tail to the base itself, as this gives you a little bit of extra posability, and that'll make sense a little bit later. Next up, we have the boat. And at this scale, it's quite difficult to convey the complex curvature and unique shaping that it has. To achieve the triangular geometry at the front of the boat, I've used a strange combination of clips and bars to create this tapered look. And due to this construction, the boat is actually built in two sub-assemblies that connect sideways in the middle. And another cool detail about the aspect of this construction is how it uses these vertical cheese slopes that form the interface between these sections. And using a similar technique, we have this here at the back of the cabin. And this parts usage allows for these really thin sections of color to show through on the build. And of course, we have Bruce the shark, built from a unique selection of elements that is very interesting. Now, as you can imagine, capturing the detail of this shark at this scale is quite a complex task, and what makes it very interesting is that it's actually symmetrically joined with the use of these two long bar elements. This gives me a lot of design freedom, especially when approximating the curvature of an animal like a shark. One of my favorite but simple parts used here is the motorcycle handlebars, which create the eyes. With the surrounding structure around it, it gives this sort of ominous but slightly comical depiction of the shark. And you'll notice that everything sort of tapers to form the nose of the shark. I don't know if that's the correct anatomical term for it, but I particularly like how the undersides of the wedge slope elements kind of intrinsically create like the nostrils. Additionally, there's this really nice color blocking that divides the dark bluish gray from the white. And hopefully that comes across fairly cleanly in the final build. Putting everything together, we have this mini diorama depicting the iconic scene with the shark and the orca, and I think it nicely represents the vibe of the scene, especially considering the limited parts budget that I had for this one. Similar to the ideas set, this one has the iconic yellow barrels at the front of the boat, as well as the shark cage at the back, and I'm sure you can see some other unique part usages as well. The central mast forms an integral part of the visual impact of this build, and as such needs to be very detailed. Again, I've used obscure elements such as the Ninjago gin blade hilt to add detail. Ultimately, I think the proportions on everything came out pretty accurately, and especially when viewing at a distance, I feel like the overall look of this diorama is actually pretty solid. I especially love the perspective of just looking directly front on at the shark. Yeah, it's definitely something. I don't know, I'm surprised how much life the eyes seem to have, despite just being a single plastic element. I find that when making microscale builds like this one, unconventional parts usage can go a long way in adding relevant details. Now, the official idea set is pretty stunning, and it does come with three brilliantly detailed figures, so it may still have the upper hand. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this showcase. If you'd like to keep up with my work, I recently launched a Flickr page that has a bunch of photos of all the models I build, so go check it out. Also, if you missed the last video, I made a showcase of my Cyberpunk build from Brickworld this year. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next video.